North Korea versus USA, whose clash at UN form as North Korea says it will not give up weapons. North Korea will never bow down to international pressure and give up its nuclear weapons program, according to the country's envoy to the United Nations, disarmament form. North Korean Ambassador Ju Yung Chol slammed the constant nuclear threats from the US and said the measures taken by the DPRK North Korea to strengthen its nuclear deterrence and develop intercontinental rockets is justifiable and a legitimate option for self-defense in the face of such apparent and real threats. He added that the North Korean nuclear program would never be up for negotiation, which could prove a serious barrier to hopes of a diplomatic solution to the ongoing tensions. U.S. Disarmament Ambassador Robert Wood told a UN-sponsored conference on disarmament in Geneva that President Trump's top priority was to protect the USA and its allies against the growing threat from North Korea, and America was ready to use the full range of capabilities at its disposal. Mr. Wood said the path to dialogue still remained an option for Pyongyang, and it had the choice between poverty and belligerence on the one hand and prosperity and acceptance on the other. Japanese Foreign Minister Taro Kono urged the international community to maintain pressure on the North to give up its nuclear weapons amid ongoing fears throughout the region. He said it was now time to exert pressure on Pyongyang after six-party talks between both Koreas, Russia, the US, China and Japan stalled. Meanwhile, joint military exercise between the US and South Korea that began yesterday are frustrating the Hermit Strait, according to Mr. Ju. He warned the ongoing military adventure would certainly add gasoline to the fire, drilling the current tension situation to further deterioration. The drills, which involve troops from the US, South Korea, Britain, Australia and elsewhere, have continued despite threats from Pyongyang. Admiral Harry Harris, the head of the US military's Pacific Command, said Washington is still hoping to reduce Washington diplomatically, which he branded the most important starting point in response to the North's threat. He said, "We hope and we work for diplomatic solutions to challenge presented by Kim Jong-un. As far as our timeline, it would be crazy for me to share with you those tripwires in advance. If we did that, it would hardly be a military strategy." Joint military drills got underway yesterday as troops carried out a simulation of nuclear war on the first day of the Alki Freedom Guardian exercises. A total of 17,500 troops took part in the exercise in Goyang, South Korea, described as being defensive in nature to prepare for war against despot leader Kim Jong-un. North Korea accused Donald Trump of adding gasoline to fire ahead of the Alchi Freedom Guardian exercises, but the Hermit Strait has been oddly quiet since the exercise began. The country's official Rodong Sinmun newspapers warned of an uncontrollable phase of a nuclear war on peninsula, which would entangle the US mainland. if the United States is lost in a fantasy that war on the peninsula is at somebody else's doorstep far away from them across the Pacific, it is far more mistaken than ever. Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and share my videos.